Not the sweet Sicily of Girard's Herbal. Myrrh, bitter myrrh, diagonal, divides my gardenless gardens incredibly as far as the eye reaches in this falling terrain. Low curled in ramshorn thickets, with hedge solid purposefulness, it unscrolls, glistening, where else the stones are white, sky blue. No beetles move, no birds pass over, the stone house is cold. The cement has crumbled from the steps. The gardens here, or fields, are weedless, not from cultivation, but from sour, unfructifying November gutters, from winds that bore no fennel seeds, finally from a sun purifying, harsh like sea salt. The stubbled grass, dragonfly green, between the stones, was not so tended. Mild animals with round, unsmiling heads cropped unprotested, unprotesting, after the rind of ice wore off the collarbones of shallow, shelving rock and went their ways. The bitter myrrh cannot revive a house abandoned. Time has bleached out the final characters of a too open scripture. Under the staring day, this rabbinical gloss rustles its leaves of living darkness. With the maps lost, the voyages cancelled by legislation years ago, this has become a territory without name. No householder survives to marvel on the threshold, even when the evening myrrh raises an aromatic incense for far ivory nostrils set in the vertical plane of ancient pride.